Hi everybody, we are here today with Silva Bortolussi. She's an associate professor at the University of Pavia in Italy and also the secretary of the International Society for Neutron Capture Therapy. I am Cetare Fotemi and with me is Agustina Portu. We both are part of the International Society of Neutron Capture Therapy and we are here to ask some questions to Silva and let's see her point of view on our society. So, Agustina, would you like to start?
Yeah, thank you very much, Cetare. Good morning to you, or whatever time is it. And hello, Silva. First of all, could you describe in your own words who you are and what you do?
Hello, Agustina and Cetare. Thank you for this interview. I'm very happy to be here and to share some views about our society and our work. I am associate professor at the University of Pavia, and I work also for INFN, National Institute of Nuclear Physics in Italy. And I work in BNCT since my master thesis degree, so it is quite a while now. And I'm currently serve as the general secretary of our society.
So as a secretary for the International Society of Neutron Capture Therapy, could you explain us what does this role entail? Which are your tasks?
I am secretary and treasurer. So in principle, I take care of the meetings, take care of organizing tasks of the society and promoting new activities, keeping the contacts among all the members of the society and all the members of the board of the society. And then I take care of the funds that are available and on keeping the, let's say, the work of the whole society from one management to the other. Now the society has been, let's say, reformed. So we have a new constitution. And the big difference is that the president is different than the president and the chair of the Congress. So now we have a more structured society. So maybe my role is more similar to the role of a general secretary of other society that you may know around the world.
Okay, thank you. This is a very interesting thing, and you have to manage a lot, I am imagining. So my question is, why did you choose this field of work, this BNCT?
It was when I was a student at Trieste University in the northeast of Italy, where a professor from Pavia came to give a talk, a seminar about BNCT in Italy. And I thought it was a very interesting thing, first of all, because the experimental work was taken at a nuclear research reactor, which was very interesting for me. Also in Italy, we have only one presently working reactor. So it was very challenging for a young student to think about this possibility. And also because it was a, let's say, a good way to use our nuclear physics knowledge to improve an aspect of society. It means apply physics to medicine.
That's very nice. So can you tell us about your career? How did you go on after your thesis?
For me, it was like this. I graduated in nuclear physics in Trieste. At that time, we didn't have a specific graduation in medical physics. But then I moved to Pavia after graduation, and I got my PhD in BNCT, so it was specifically on medical physics. And then I started my university career with postdocs, and then fixed term position as a researcher. And after that, I got my tenure track at the University of Pavia. So I had 3 years of tenure researcher and then associated professor. During my career, I developed some interest in some multidisciplinary aspects of our research work, specifically to technology transfer, which means the idea of transferring some research work and result into society. So to improve this capability, I also did a master in open innovation and technology transfer at the University of Milan.
So, Sil, which research topics in BNCT interest you most, and what do you think are the future challenges in this field?
So, when I started, I felt more interested in the physics aspects of BNCT, so mainly the neutron physics and the neutron interaction in matter. Recently, my research work is connected more to the study of biological effects of BNCT in cells and in patients.
So this is very interesting, and I think it's a nice subject which you were talking about, but I want also to speak about challenges. So I would like to know which are the challenges that you had to face maybe during your career, and I don't know, what do you think about it?
Challenges in our works are many, and some of them are quite difficult to solve. In particular, and I speak about my experience in Italy system, the most difficult challenge is to get a permanent position, because it is quite easy to enter a group, a research group, as a student, as a master thesis student, or a PhD. But then it's difficult to remain. So one of the challenges that we have to face is that it is difficult to form a stable group of research. And once you have formed some collaborators that usually are really valuable and contributory, then you have no resources to keep them working with you, and you have to start all over again. So one of the challenges in our system is that for projects like BNCT application, which are very complex to build, and you need many people in different areas of knowledge working hard on one project, it's difficult to build a group. So I think that in my case, this would be the most important thing, thinking about future of BNCT, having the possibility to gather people able to do this work with the right knowledge and the right experience to go from basic research to clinical application.
So not to leave on a sad note about challenges, what do you think could make life easier for a young researcher?
Well, I think that the solution stays in the international collaboration. Also, for this reason, I think that is very important to keep the society very active and very young, because only with international networking, people can have a good start in one group and then move in another group, maybe in another country, bringing new competence, but also enlarging the possible collaboration that then give rise to big projects. So even if it is not possible sometimes to get a fixed position where one has started, maybe it's possible to go on with collaboration with collaborators abroad. So also for this reason, I think that our society is a very powerful tool to help people and also to help BNCT.
And I would also like to know what are the positive and interesting aspects of your work, and if you could give us some examples.
For sure, the the most important thing is that you know many people, because you are forced to talk not only with physicists in my case, but also with biologists, with chemists, with pharmacologists, and with medical doctors. We know that we all speak different languages somehow, but still, to make BNCT work, you have to learn how to communicate and how to put together the efforts to reach the final goal, that is treatment of patients. So the most important thing is that you have the possibility to grow as a person also, not only as a scientist, because you see things from a different perspective. So you have to abandon your status and be ready to negotiate things. And in this process, you learn things also for your personal life. This is my experience. Also, you travel, you stay with other people, you learn other cultures, and you see that things may be done in a different things. This effort of internationalization in BNCT, I think, is the most powerful tool that we have to spread BNCT ideas, because we know that BNCT is not easy to apply. So only as a whole society we can spread the idea and promote the application.
That's an amazing approach, Silva, what you mentioned. It's really interesting, and it connects with my next question, because you have many collaborators around the world. So how is working with so many different realities?
For me, it's almost natural. I mean, I started with in this way, and for me, it's very normal to consider myself as part of a bigger group, not only the group that works every day in the same office, but having constant interaction with groups working abroad. The only problem is the different hours, so the meetings can be in very different times of the day, but this is nothing compared to the things that you gain. In fact, I feel that my work wouldn't have been possible without a very important collaboration abroad that I still keep, because I feel that we are part of the same group, really. And the way that we have to keep this collaboration alive and suitable for BNCT goals is to exchange people, especially, of course, a young researcher and people who can spend some time in another country. Because the possibility to mix people, not only in the hours of the work, but also personally, allows to form a real group. So in my experience, the possibility to set up a people exchange is very important and should be promoted also inside our society, promoted and helped.
I think this is a very interesting point of view. And I believe also that having this mix and match of people around the world could be very useful. So I would like to ask you, which is a piece of advice or something you would like to tell a young researcher that is starting in our field?
Of course, to be very open, to learn different things, to work in different environments, for example, to mix with other disciplines, like, for example, biology or chemistry, to not be afraid of move, to go abroad, to start very early a personal network of persons, because only with personal networks one can find its own or her own way to the future. So don't be afraid, be proactive, and propose things and try to feel always free to start the ideas that you have in mind. Because in a way or in the other, if you are strong willing, you can.
That's, I think it would be very inspiring for many young researchers in our field. So thank you very much, Silva, for having answered all our questions. Thank you, Agus, for being here with me, talking to Silva. And from me, I say goodbye. See you next video.